हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू साइंस वर्ल्ड एंड आई होप यू आर डूइंग वेल एंड गेटिंग हेल्प फ्रॉम माई वीडियोज़। इन आवर लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द 13th चैप्टर, दैट इज़ फ्रॉम वन एंड टू द अदर, एंड इट वॉज द फर्स्ट वीडियो ऑफ दिस टॉपिक एंड वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रोडवेज एंड रेलवेज। टुडे वी हैव सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ दैट वीडियो एंड सेम चैप्टर वी विल डिस्कस एंड द टॉपिक्स दैट विल हैव दैट आर वाटरवेज एंड एयरवेज। ओके, सो लेट स्टार्ट। We will start with waterways. We know that about 3/4 of the earth is covered with water, and as we know that in ancient times boats were developed for navigation and fishing. There were no ships, only they were using boats and rafts. However, with the development of civilization, larger vessels were developed for the trade and war, and as there was a development in the civilization, people or ancient people, they started develop larger ships and larger boats for the trading and wars. So let's see the pictures. This is the earth, and we know that it's 3/4 part of the earth is covered with water. So this is the first we can say boat like structure, that is raft, was made by the early people in ancient times, and these were made by using the logs of woods. So this was the first thing that they used for water transport. Then this is the ship that was, this type of ships were used by the ancient time, or we can say early times sailors like Columbus, Magellan and Vasco da Gama. So these were the ships they used. These are also different designs of the ships used by people in olden times. You can see the different designs here also, this one, this one. So these are the different pictures of the ships. Then we know that there was a industrial revolution in 17th century, 17th to 18th century. So this, during this time, during this industrial revolution, steamboats were developed. Okay, and later diesel power ships were also invented. So you can see the pictures of this steamboat. See, these boats were used steam engines and diesel for running. So these are the pictures of steamboats and diesel engine ships. But nowadays there are many types of ships and crews, like luxury liners. These luxury liners are the ships in that you will get all types of necessary services, like you will get the luxurious rooms and nice food, you will have shops for shopping, then you will have swimming pool and many other things included in this luxury liners. Then tankers, freighters are being used to take goods and people from one place to another place. So tankers and freighters are used for carrying goods, and luxury liners and other ships, they are used to carry people from one place to another place. People traveling in luxury liners and cruise ships get all the necessary services. You can see the pictures here. See, this is the Ocean Rebellion. This is the cruise ship. Here also you can see this luxurious swimming pool is there. All the arrangements are there. Then this much big is the luxury ship. Here you can see different types of facilities are there. You can do shopping, you can get different food items. Here also you can see, this is the dining hall or restaurant, and these are the luxurious rooms in the this liners or luxury liners. Students, do you know there are many famous cruise ships in the world, like Sundarbans luxury cruise. Now I am telling you some names of Indian cruise or Indian ships, like Sundarban luxury cruise, then the Oberoi motor vessel, Vrinda cruise, River Ganges heritage cruise, Goa cruise destination, Costa Neo Classica cruise, Kerala backwaters cruise, then Andaman Islands cruise, and finally the Jalesh cruise. So you can see the picture here. This is the picture of Jalesh cruise. This is the luxurious liner or ship. You will get everything on this ship. Then the world's most luxurious ship is the Regent Seven Seas Explorer. The Regent Seven Seas Explorer is the world's most luxurious ship, and you can see the pictures here. Then Viking Ocean Cruise and Seabourn are another world's luxurious ships. So this is all about the ships that carry people. But what about other goods? So for transportation of oil, it is transported in oil tankers to different parts of the world, while the freighters carry huge amounts of food, machines, and timber. Then freighters are the type of ships that are used to carry food and machines and timber. Cargo ships are used to ferry heavy cargo. Heavy like machineries are there. So this type of heavy cargoes are carried by cargo ships. Then waterways are used on a large scale by countries across the world. This is very important questions. Question: why waterways are used on a large scale by countries across the world? And the answer is they are the most economical means of transport and also need relatively lower maintenance. Now, economical means they are cheap. The services or waterways, they give cheap services. That means less money is needed for transportation. And second thing, maintenance. Maintenance means waterways do not need tracks like railways or roads like buses. For buses and trucks, we may have to make the roads. Okay, roads and highways. But this water transport, they do not need roadways like roads and this railway tracks. Okay, that's why waterways are used on a large scale by countries across the world to carry people and heavy goods. Here you can see the tankers. This is a tanker ship. It is known as tanker. This is also a tanker. So these are used for carrying oil and gas. Then here is the cargo ship. This contains this transports heavy goods like machineries and other heavy goods. Then the South Atlantic route and North Atlantic route are important waterways of the world. When we talk about the world, there are two routes that are most important. That is South Atlantic and North Atlantic routes. And these routes were explored by the people like Columbus, Magellan, and Vasco da Gama because they were the sailor and they covered most of the distance, or they sailed through the seas and oceans and they found out these routes. The former means the Atlantic, South Atlantic route, it connects Europe and South America, and the North Atlantic route connects Europe and North America. So I will show you the map here. Here you can see South Atlantic and North Atlantic. Now this is the Atlantic Ocean here. This is the North Atlantic route. It connects North America and Europe. Then this South America and Europe is connected by the South Atlantic route. Then you can see again here. So these are the two routes, South Atlantic route and North Atlantic route. Then inland waterways are also important as they help a lot in transportation. Now inland waterways means the canal that is man-made, just like to connect two seas or rivers, or to take water to the different parts of the country from a sea or a dam. These canals are made by us, and these canals are the inland waterways. Okay, then big rivers are there. Many big rivers has this water transport systems also. So inland waterways are also important, like rivers, canals, and lakes. So this is the map. You can see here all the oceans: Pacific Ocean, then Atlantic Ocean, Indian Ocean, etc. Now you can see here the route that is from Portugal here to this India. So this route was used by Vasco da Gama, who first reached India. And he traveled from Portugal, that is from Europe. But he came to this way, like here. So he came by this long route, and he covered a large distance in the sea, and he came to this Cape of Good Hope. It is the part of Africa, and in this way he reached India in 1498. So this was the first time when people reach India through these waterways. Then, what is a canal? A canal is a waterway that is constructed by humans for transporting people, ships, and goods. Just now I told you that there are man-made structures like canals. They are for transporting people and goods. So transporting goods by ship is cheaper as compared to the roadways and airways. For this purpose, we made Suez Canal, that is 163 kilometers long. This Suez Canal is 163 kilometers long in Egypt, and it links two seas, that is Red Sea and the Mediterranean Sea. So this Suez Canal links two seas, Red Sea and Mediterranean Sea. Earlier, ships were traveling from Europe to the Middle East, had to go around the Africa. Just now we have seen that if you want to go this Middle East or towards India, or you want to go to Europe, then you have to go around this Africa, like this. You have to cover that much distance. But after constructing this Suez Canal, this distance was nearly half. It has been reduced to the half distance almost. So you can see here, this is the Mediterranean Sea here, and this is the Red Sea. Now these two seas are connected by constructing a canal here. So this is known as Suez Canal, and it is the very important route nowadays because it connects the important parts of the world, through this Suez Canal. So this is here, you can see Indian Ocean, here Mediterranean Sea and the Red Sea. So this is the Suez Canal. So after opening the Suez Canal, this traveling time has been reduced by almost half. Before, people were coming around, they have to travel around the Africa, but now they are traveling through this canal. Then second canal is Panama Canal, and it connects the Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. Atlantic and Pacific Oceans. This canal is about 50 kilometers long, and its construction began in 1881 by the French, but it was later abandoned as the digging had to be done through a long stretch of hot disease-infested jungles. And that's why this canal took very long time to complete its construction. So the canal was completed in 1914 by the United States of America. Almost 56,307 people were involved in the construction of this Panama Canal. So it is 50 kilometers long. Now you can see the picture here. This is the Panama Canal here. Panama Canal, and it connects North America and South America. So before people, if they have to travel to this side, that is to the Europe and other Middle East countries, then they have to travel from North America. So they have to cover a long distance through this Pacific Ocean and Atlantic Ocean. But after construction of this Panama Canal here, this route or this distance was reduced. Now they can travel directly from here to this Europe, or they can go to the Middle East countries. So Panama Canal route, it is near about 8,000 miles, and Cape Horn route is 16,000 miles. So you can understand how much long this distance is. So before they were traveling 16,000 miles, but now they are traveling only 8,000 miles, means just half. Half distance they have to cover now. Then we have next topic, that is aviation or air transport. So when we talk about air transport, we know that it is the most costly transport system, but it takes very less time. The first we will read about the history. The first form of man-made flying objects were kites. Kites were the first man-made flying objects, and these were invented by Chinese people in 400 BCE. This was followed by hydrogen balloons. After these kites, hydrogen balloons were made in the 17th and 18th century. You can see the pictures here. So this was the first kite. It was made, or it was invented by the Chinese people. Then here, this is the another type of flying object. Then in 1783, a duck, a sheep, and a rooster flew in a hot air balloon made of linen and paper by the Montgolfier brothers. So this was a hot air balloon. Then in 1849, a glider designed Sir George Galilei lifted a 10-year-old boy into the air. So this was another invention in 1849. Then you can see here, Henry Gifford puts the first airship into the flight, 1852. Then 1879, Victor Tatym built two compressed air model airplanes which flew successfully. Then in 1903, in Kitty Hawk, North Carolina, Orville Wright became the first to achieve controlled power flight. He stayed about for 12 seconds. And in 1907, Paul Cornu, a Frenchman, built the first free flying helicopter. So this is the development in the field of aviation. Students, did you know that Leonardo da Vinci designed the ornithopter, that is a wing-flapped aircraft that closely looked like the anatomy of a bird? After him, many inventions were made. So this is the picture of Leonardo da Vinci and the ornithopter that is made by him. So this was the first flying invention that was made by him, and he took idea from the anatomy of the bird, that means the body structure of a bird. So this was the first trial, or we can say first invention made by him. After him, many inventions were made. You can see this, the ornithopter, first man-made flying object, or man operating flying object we can say. Then after him, Wilbur and Orville Wright brothers. These are the Wilbur and Orville Wright brothers. And it was only in 1903 that these brothers invented an aeroplane. This was the aeroplane, and it was named the Flyer. And the flight lasted for about 12 seconds. So this flyer aeroplane, it lasted its flight for about 12 seconds. So, and it covered a distance about 230 meters. So 230 meter distance was covered by this aeroplane. You can see another picture here. So this was the first invention that was made by the Wright brothers, and this was the starting of new era in aviation, or we can say air transport. Today, the supersonic planes carrying hundreds of passengers, cargo, perishable items, and traveling across seas and continents. Now, supersonic planes means these planes have a very high speed. Supersonic means they can travel more than faster, more than the, or we can say faster than the speed of the sound. So these are the supersonic planes. These carry hundreds of passengers, cargo, or we can say goods, and perishable items. Perishable items means that can be destroyed if they are kept for longer time. So these perishable items are transported in a less time and traveling across the seas and continents. These days, all important cities of the world, they are linked by the air. Airways are the fastest and most expensive means of transport, but they are comfortable and prestigious also. Okay, they are comfortable and prestigious. It can cover very difficult terrains like high mountains. So these helicopters and aeroplanes, they can reach to the high mountains. They can also fly over the deserts. They can also fly over the dense forest, long oceanic stretches with ease. They are easily traveling through all the corners of the world. This air transport system is also useful in the rescue operations during floods, earthquakes, forest fires, and other natural calamities. And it is also useful in the defense of the country. This is very important part of the air transport, and also for export and import from the different countries. So that is why airways are the very important transport system for a country, as it is useful in the rescue operations, it is also useful for the defense of country, it is also useful in export and import of the goods, and it is also useful for carrying people because it is comfortable and prestigious. Here you can see the pictures of the supersonic planes. These are the supersonic planes. Then we will talk about the air transport in India. In India, military and civil aviations are there. Military is for the defense services and civil aviation is for the civil people that are living in the country. Okay, so Air India and India Airlines. Air India and India Airlines manage the air transport in India, both the flights, that is for domestic and international. So domestic means the flights that can or we can say the flight system or air transport during only for the country, within the country only. Okay, so these planes fly within the country, and international flights, they visit or they give their services around the world. There are currently 39 airlines operating in India. IndiGo is the fastest company or largest company, following which are SpiceJet, Go Air, Air Asia, Air India Express. These are different aviation companies that are providing services in India. So here you can see these are the planes, fighter jets and fighter planes are there, and these are always ready for the defense of our country. Then here you can see the different aviation companies in India: Air Asia, IndiGo, SpiceJet, Jet Airways. Here also you can see Vistara, Go Air, in Air Asia, Jet Airways, Air India, IndiGo, TriJet, JetLite, and SpiceJet. So these are the different companies that are providing their services to the people in India. So here we have finished our second part of this chapter number 13, and we have discussed about the waterways and aviation or air transport. So for next topic, you keep watching my videos, and please like, comment and share with your friends. Also subscribe my channel and keep the bell icon on so that you will get the notification of my upcoming videos. So thank you for watching video. We will meet again in our next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye.